Hi there, this is Luv Johar, and in this particular training video of ISO 27001, ISMS 27001, we will try to understand what exactly do we mean by gap analysis in ISO 27001, ISMS, that is the importance of gap analysis in ISO 27001 information security management system. So ISO 27001 gap analysis is basically the process of identifying what your business is currently doing in order to protect its information assets, and comparing those measures to what your business must do in order to be compliant to the ISO 27001 information security management system standard. So this basically means that the gap analysis actually compares your existing security controls against those which are already established in the ISO 27001 standard in order to identify the gaps which you can actually try to fill later on as per the requirements that have been suggested in ISO 27001. So you can see that gap analysis is nothing but the overall assessment of your information security management system, that is your current situation analysis, in order to analyze the gaps in your existing security posture of your organization. So at the end of gap assessment, you will be able to identify which ISO 27001 controls your organization has in place and which controls you still need to implement. So now you must be thinking, what are the different factors that can influence this gap analysis process, which means that what factors can identify the time requirements for the gap analysis process. So the basic things are, it basically depends upon the size of your organization and the overall scope which you have defined for your ISMS project. So now, coming down to the main factors, as I've said, that can affect the influence of the gap analysis process, primarily the gap analysis will depend upon the scope and business drivers for implementing ISO 27001 that you have defined in your ISMS implementation project, which means that the time duration and complexities involved in performing the gap analysis will actually depend upon the basic scope of the project which you have identified. So now it comes back to the real gap analysis process involved. There are some basic overview of steps which are involved in primarily in the gap analysis process. The first step is actually to conduct a high level review of all your security documentations which are currently in place in order to discover the current policies and procedures within your organization. So in this step, basically you have to identify what all documents, policies and procedures are there in your existing organization and which are the different documents and policies and procedures that you are lacking in. So this is the step one for ISO 27001 gap analysis. And the second step actually will be to conduct some interviews with the key process owners for all the different processes which you have within your organization in order to understand the actual security practices which are in place and which are basically in use on a day-to-day basis within your organization. So these practical interviews will actually help you in order to find out what is happening in reality in your organization versus what has been written in those policies and procedures that you have documented and maintained in some internet website. So this will actually help you to understand where the actual implementation of these policies is happening or not, and within the areas of the organization. You can actually see by these interviews where are these policies and procedures actually lacking on. So after these two steps are completed, the third and final step which comes to the gap analysis will be comparing the findings of the above two exercises with the standard requirements of ISO 27001 and measuring where you stand in terms of your overall requirements that you need to fulfill in order to comply with ISO 27001 standard, and where are you, current situation at. So after this assessment is over, you should ideally prepare a gap analysis report with all your findings in it. So what you can do is you can also segregate your findings in different levels and different priorities so that they can be treated as per your defined priority levels. So first level of your current security posture could be that compliant, you might be compliant, which means that the organization is fully compliant. For example, the requirements and controls that have been identified are implemented, and measurement and review of all the controls are performed on regular intervals. The second level of your current security posture as per the gap analysis that you have done could be partially compliant, which means that the organization has gone some way towards being compliant and is currently in progress of implementing some controls in place But you still require some additional work to be undertaken. For example, requirements and the necessary controls implementation have been planned but not implemented at the moment. The third level of your current security posture could be non-compliant, which means that the organization does not have any necessary controls in place in order to satisfy all the requirements in ISO 27001. And this basically means that the requirements have neither been identified, not been planned, and not even implemented at this moment. So now you must be thinking, what will we get from the gap analysis of ISO 27001? From this report, what exactly will we get, and what exactly will we get from all these assessments that we are planning to conduct? So at the end of the gap analysis report, you will actually have a rough estimated time and effort required to implement an ISO 27001 project. So it will basically give you an overview of how much time and effort you will need. So gap analysis will be very much required when writing this statement of applicability document also, which is called SOA in other terms. So now, in order to summarize again at the end, gap analysis is nothing but reading, understanding and analyzing each clause of ISO 27001 and confirming if that requirement is already implemented within your organization at the moment or not. If not, then you have to mention the same in your gap analysis findings report. So that's it for this particular training video. I request you to please subscribe to my channel if you are really interested to study about ISO 27001 and if you want to understand the implementation of ISO 27001. And information security management system is a very vast topic, so please ensure that you subscribe to get the most knowledge out of these videos. If you have any questions, by any chance, please feel free to comment below and I will be really happy to respond back. This is Luv Johar. Thanks so much for watching. Thank you.